Hey guys, welcome to another episode of What Talking Master. Sorry, I lost my train of thought there. Today we're going to talk about what I got in this month's MTB Pro Box, as long as my stuff from Doug Designs, my jerseys come in, which I'm wearing one of them, and my hoodie come in, and also how I done the tournament this week, where I'm looking at and the points for the Mountain Division. So let's get into this. Hope y'all enjoy it and stay tuned. Guys, now that we're back, we'll start with the Dub Design stuff. Just get that out the way. I love the guy. Chris Hayes is amazing. Nicole in the office is great. They took good care of me. I got the Cryptek pattern in the jersey. Show teams right here in a minute. But he asked me what colors I wanted, and I told him the green or the yellow. Black and gray. Other than that, I didn't care. Do whatever you want. So he took that. He done his art thing. Chris's is great. He does all the artwork. He done my logo for Watauga Basser. So like he designed it and completely made it for me. So I'll show you these and we'll get to it. Okay, so if you can't see my head, it don't matter. We're looking at the jerseys. So, Dub Designs, Cryptek pattern. Has my Watauga Basser down the sleeve. Green and white. I think it looks good. And y'all know I was in the Marine Corps. I told you that in my first couple videos. I had to get, of course, the Support Our Troops American flag, red, white, and blue. Got the American flag here. Down here around the soldiers. Dub Designs. Tim Horton. Watauga Basser. The Bass Fishing League. BFL. Got my name down the sleeves. Also got the flag on both sleeves. It's your nice hood. Same on the back. With my name at the top, Horton. Man, I love this thing. I wore it over the weekend, this past tournament yesterday. Oh, they also do hats. Move the chair back over here to where it was to begin with. So, I love it. I kind of told him to do his thing. He done it. He's a great guy. If y'all want anything from them, they do. Man, Dub Designs Pro does uniforms in general. Jerseys especially, like jerseys in general. They do hoodies, team hoodies. They do jerseys, soccer jerseys, baseball jerseys, fishing jerseys, short sleeve, long sleeve. American flag on the sides of them. They zip, they unzip, nice collars, breathable material. Great, just absolutely great. They also do Dub Designs, their sister company. They do t-shirts, team shirts, fire department, police, your fire department that you're in specifically, your team stuff. They'll do any t-shirts. Their design or custom designs, whichever you want. So go check them out. I'll leave a link in the description below to their page. If you decide you want something, give them a call. Make sure you just told them that Timothy Horton, Watauga Basser, Tim Horton, Watauga Basser, sent you over there. You've got the link through my page. Help me out a little bit. It helped y'all out. will be able to do this. I'll be able to keep doing this and be able to keep trying to get better. So, I know this stuff ain't good for you, but I need a drink. Next up, we got the MTB Pro Box. Yes, I did already open it. Kind of took a peek of what's inside. I like everything that's in here. There's only one thing that I don't use a lot that is in here. And a type of worm that I wanted to try out. So let's get into this. First up, we got the Dibbles Digest. This month's has Nico Rig 411, Best Ways to Imitate Crawfish, All About Crayfish, and 3 Shad Imitators. These are actually pretty good. I read the last one I got, and it has some good stuff in it. The card, we need that. Little crankbait sticker, that'll go on one of my Plano boxes. Now let's do this down the line here. This box costs $25. I'll leave a link to MTB in the bottom. I don't have a pro code because I'm not sponsored or pro staff with Mystery Tackle Box. But I'll leave you the link anyway. You can go look at the stuff. $25 for about $45, $50 worth of stuff every month. So let's get to it. So, first up, we got Live Target Sunfish Hollow Body Topwater. It's up here. But we can take a look at this. Okay, so, topwater hollow body, like a hollow body frog kind of deal. Has trocar hooks, which is nice if I can get it out of the package. These type of baits, these hollow bodies or any top water, I don't much care what the top looks like. I mean, it's got a good paint job on it. It's pretty. They got the hooks as such to where they shouldn't get hung up too much. Should be alright. And you got enough room to get a hook set. Get a decent hook set. Those trocar hooks are sticky. I care about what the bottom looks like. I might give it a little white paint or something just to kind of, or I may leave it alone. I don't know. We'll figure it out, or I'll figure it out when the time comes. But that's a good looking little old bait. I don't get to use it much. Maybe on Watts Bar I'll get to use it, or if I make it to the regional on Chick, that would be nice. Okay. And that is $12.99, so might as well say $13 for that one bait. And that was from ICAST 2015. Next up is the Yozuri 3DS Shad. Now, that's not a bad looking little bait. Something I would definitely use. It's kind of like a small jerk bait type thing. It's a shallow runner. Suspending. Dives 3.5 foot max. It's a 1/4 ounce weight, 2 5/8 inches. Come on, come out of there. If I can get it to come out, anyway. Little bait, good shark hooks. Yep. That's actually a good looking little bait. I will definitely put that to use sometime in the near future. Because sometimes you get that bait, those bait fish that the bass and stuff are eating on that are that size. And when they're that size, you can throw something bigger. And sometimes you can't get a bite. Something like that, you throw it, you may have to throw it on a spinning gear. But that right there will get you bit for sure. Definitely going to put that to use. So what's next? The True Spin by Lucker Hunt. I don't know what it is, but we'll take a look. This is a little trout style. It looks like a baby trout, like a little trout minnow. 3 13/16 ounce weighted lure. Looks like a little, whoa. Hey, almost fell out of there on me. You stay in there to where I can get this done. Let these folks see it. Come on now. See if I can do this here. You know what? The heck with it. I'll just do it this way. I know y'all gonna be able to see it. Okay, so it is a little trout style weighted. That's a solid weight bait. Which around here with a smallmouth, especially smallmouth on these lakes that we have that have trout in them. Little baby trout, little spinner. Fish it deep. It's got a little, actually got a nice little treble hook on it. I will definitely be using that. I don't know how exactly I'll use it yet. Whether I may jig it, I may swim it a little bit. I'll have to look and see if it has any action. I doubt it does. I about bet it's like a jerk style bait or something like a spoon or something. But we'll, let's read. Yeah, don't say exactly how to use it. But we'll see. I'm definitely going to try it, though. Even in the river at the house, I'll throw it and swim it back at the river. For smallmouth, it ought to work pretty well. So that was $7. So right now we're at 13 and 7, 20, and then 10 for the 3DS shad from Missouri. So we're at $30. We paid 25. So we're already to $30. We're over with those three baits. So next up is the Swagger Worm by Buddha Baits. It's $5.49. Never heard of the bait company. It's a watermelon color. Watermelon green, watermelon black flake. Watermelon black, I guess you'd call it. Flake. Woo! That is garliced out, guys. So it's a paddle tail worm. Has a little slit in it. You can pull it apart. It's going to give that tail a little more action or a little different action. I wish that I had this over the weekend. But that's actually a good looking worm. I'm definitely going to throw it. That is, how much is, oh, that's 5 feet. It's worth $35.50, y'all. Definitely going to use this special in a couple weeks at Holston. Tournament up there, and it's going to be a crazy tournament. Next is the Z-Man Grass Kickers. They are $4.50. So we're at $40. This is the Z-Man, the Elastec Grass Kickers. Elastec, y'all. It's supposed to be some good stuff. It's the blueback herring color. I'm still probably going to throw it around here, even though we do not have herring in this lake. Because that's a good looking bait, and I'm sure it'll work. It is a solid body. It does have a little slit in the bottom. Has two dorsal fins really close together. It's a 5-inch bait. Good looking bait, big boot tail. That's gonna be a nice bait for when we're doing the A-rig thing, which I don't care much for, but it'll work when that's going on. When the A-rig is in, that's when these will be used mostly. I mean, I'll throw them just like a regular swim bait. But I don't throw swim bait a little much. I don't throw an A-rig a bunch. But grass kickers. And it being the last take, I'm going to test that out, actually. Because I have never seen the last take. I've seen people play with it, and they say it stretches. Damn. No, sorry, y'all, but put it back. Exact same shape. I'll be dang. I'm definitely going to try these. Because, something like that, I can get a lot of bites. I catch a lot of fish on something like that throughout the day. Especially if it's as tough as what they say it is. Get it back in the package here. And those, we already went over how much those were. Let's see. Last is the Super Swimmer Junior by Bruiser Baits. This is $1.80 here at $41.80 for this box. I'm going to say that this is a sample pack. And it is. Because it's just four and it's just $1.80. So this is a sample pack. These are like 2 inch. 2.5 inch. Be great for a Carolina rig or a trailer on a spinner bait or chatter bait or a swim jig or even a small swim bait. Nice little boot tail. Nice color. It's like a gray, like a blue gray color, like a blueback herring color. I about bet they put this box out because it's a classic. There's a blueback herring. It's a herring. It's a herring lake. So, ain't bad. There's only one of those that I ain't going to get to use a lot. And that I ain't going to get a whole lot of use out of. And that's that live target. I don't use them much. We don't have hardly any grass. And we have a bunch of frogs, but very few get bit around here. And we do get bites off of frogs, just very, very seldom. So, that's the MTB Pro Box. It's not a bad deal. I'll leave a link in the description below. Next up, let's talk about the tournament series as I'm doing. First off, I'm doing the Volunteer Division, which is the Tennessee. And I'm also doing the Mountain Division, which is the Kentucky Division. We've had two tournaments of the Kentucky Division. We've had one of the Volunteer, the Tennessee Division, or Mountain Division, the Volunteer Division. So, our first tournament Volunteer Division was on the Norris. I turned in 4 fish. Ended up getting 26. So, I'm sitting pretty good in points right now. We've got South Holston Lake, or Reservoir. And then we've got Cherokee after that, and then Douglas left. And then the Super Tournament in September. And then the Regional. Super Tournament's going to be on Watts Bar. So, I'm sitting in 26th in points, which ain't bad. I'm happy with that for now. Next up is the Mountain Division. I am sitting in 54th in points for the Mountain Division. I believe, I'm not for sure, I have to check again, but I believe you have to be in the top 40 to be able to go to the Regional. We've still got, we've still got 3 left with them too. We've got Cumberland Lake, Barron River, and those are right around June. Or May and June, somewhere around there. And then we have, May 3rd, or May 5th is the Kentucky Lake, and then June is the Barron River. And then we have the Super Tournament at the Barron River again. So I should be all right to make it there. I'm hoping if everything keeps going the way it's going, I'll be set. I'll be able to get in there. Everything will be good. So, that's all I have for y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Like I always say, fish every cast like it's your last. Make sure you get out there and fish. Do whatever you can to teach somebody about fishing or take somebody. Give somebody something to do. Get somebody sitting, a friend that's sitting at the house by themselves. Make them go fishing. That's just what I'd do. So, if y'all like the video, remember which way it goes. If y'all like the video, leave the like out, push the like button down here.